I have two Pong systems here from the 70s. Both were thrift store finds. This one is a Unisonic Tournament 100. And I was actually able to find some information on it online. And it was introduced in 1976. It has two joysticks, which are detachable. But I don't want to take them out right now because the cord is all coiled up inside. And if you pull it out, then it all comes out and you have to spend, you know, 5 minutes winding it up again to get it neatly in the housing. Unfortunately, it does not work. It runs on 6 C-cell batteries. It has a built-in speaker, various options here. And when you turn it on, the screen goes white and the hiss reduces, so it is putting out a signal, but it doesn't do anything. You know, I tried the various switches and there's nothing on the screen except blank white. And I opened it up and I tested all the switches and they're all okay, so it's something wrong with the circuitry, which, as typical for older video games, is enclosed in a thick metal shielding that's soldered together, so it's gonna be a real pain to get that apart, even to see if he can possibly fix it. So it's a project for another day, if ever. And this one came in its original box. It's a Coleco. Well, it's actually Radofin, distributed by Coleco. Sort of a handheld thing. Runs on 6 AA batteries. And this one is actually working. It also came with the original, very retro-looking switch box, which I don't use because I just use one of those plug adapters so I can plug it right in. This one is on channel 3. It doesn't have a switch for channel 3 or 4, at least not that I found. So, and both of these are black and white, by the way. I'll turn this one on. I'll set it to practice. Let's see if I can turn down the brightness a little bit for the camera. That should be better. All right. That's just the practice. Now I'll set it to the classic Pong game, which it's hard to play one-handed. There's different options here for ball speed, so now it really goes flying. Can barely even hit it. Ball angle, which means when you hit it, it makes a more angled trajectory. Why is it going right through the paddle? Must be a glitch. And player size, which gives you small paddles. Let's try squash. Probably the switches need some cleaning. Alright, something's wrong here. It's going right through the paddles. Alright. Come on. There we go. Let's see if squash works now. So you sort of bounce it off of the wall. Now hockey, which is a very simplistic rendition of the game, as you can see. So it leaves a lot to your imagination, as you can see. But this was actually state of the art for home video games until the Atari 2600 came along and opened the world up to more different styles of video games than just you know, ball and paddle type games. I like the logos they give to make it look like the actual sports. Tennis, practice, hockey, squash, tennis practice. They say it twice. Handheld video game. Let's see. Four action-packed black and white games. Three different sounds. Three different beeps. Automatic on-screen digital scoring. Separate player controls mean players can sit or stand up to 4 feet apart. Made in Hong Kong. So I paid $4.99 for this. So there's the two different Pong systems. Imagine this one be a little more advanced, but still black and white. And still only four games, so maybe even practically the same here. Really the same options on both, just a fancier desktop model with a built-in speaker. This one is actually better because it goes through the TV and wonderful black and white. And this is a color set, you just don't know it because it's a black and white video game. So those are the state-of-the-art 70s home video games here from Radofin / Coleco and Unisonic. Hope you enjoyed the video.